Hello, everyone. Time has come to answer all your questions. And I will start from the ones you asked under my 200 sub special YouTube video. So, here we go. How long did it take to create your series? Well, if you're talking about one episode, it usually takes like a month or maybe like 2 months, but at least it was with first three episodes. But then, well, the fourth one, which I'm doing right now, I don't know when I finish it because like I don't have much time, so probably it will take like 4 months maybe, counting one or two that have passed already. I don't know. Question is weird because like I haven't finished those yet. I'm only like doing episodes, but yeah, something like 1 month if I'm not busy, and from up to 4 months if I'm busy for each episode, I think. Oh, well, also I have problems with voice actors where some of them just disappear, like, whoa, I agreed at first, but then, oh, school is hard, you know, school is hard, oh, I don't know, dude, this is weird, what they will do when they go to college, whatever. So, next question, what is your favorite musician? Oh, that's a nice question. If you're talking about a single one, not like a band, oh well, I'll probably say that's Clayton from Cell Dweller, Circle of Dust, Scandroid, where else, he has many projects, but yeah, I think this guy, which is, I think he's Scott Albert, I'm not sure, but yeah, Clayton from Cell Dweller is my favorite musician, I guess. What is your favorite film? That's a difficult one. I don't know. Okay. Probably, maybe Watchmen. I'm not sure though, because like it's very hard to pick a favorite movie, song, like stuff like that. It's like downright impossible in some cases. I don't know. I would say Watchmen, but I'm not sure with that. Maybe I can remember something better. I don't know. I like TV series more, and like any series, to be honest. Because, well, more effort, longer story, more details, and whatnot. What is your least favorite Bionicle character? So, how do I say that? I don't know almost anything about Bionicle lore, so I probably don't know anything about most of the characters, so I don't think I can answer that question. I like Bionicles because of the sets and pieces, and that you can animate them and create mocks. I usually don't give a fuck about lore whatsoever. Though I know that this lore is really cool, and for a toy line lore to be that good is like I didn't hear about any other toy line with lore that good, so yeah, I acknowledge that this lore is really, really well detailed and like dark and edgy and whatnot, but I don't know what's my favorite Bionicle character. What kind of filming equipment do you use? So, I use a camera. I use a tripod which has broken legs, so I glue them with the clay. And this tripod is really bad and I need to buy a new one. What else? I use green screen. And I use lamps, of course. I want like show photos because lamps. Those are just table lamps, not like professional big square ones for photography, because I'm I guess I'm poor, I don't know. Maybe I need to buy those lamps. Yeah. Also, I use clay, but I need to start using magnets, because clay makes your mug's feet dirty, and it's cool for blood and whatnot and some effects, but not for gluing your mugs, because if you can find good magnets, like not just any magnets, but really strong ones, those would be much better, because yeah, no dirt, no clay stains, no nothing, like, and your hands won't be dirty, and this is just like, it looks better because you can animate feet, obviously. But yeah. Next. On a scale of 1 to 10, what's your favorite color of the alphabet in whole numbers? 1488. How many balls do you have in exact numbers? Exact numbers. Okay, let me check. Two. What inspires you for your mug creations? So sometimes I get ideas from my sleep, but this like happens not that often, almost never actually. But mostly I just like either sit somewhere and something pops up in my head, but. No, it's not mostly, it's also like happens sometimes. Mostly I just like look at my parts, see many colors and like, well, those can look good. And I just like, basically, yeah, I'm not that good with character designs in terms of their like personality and whatnot, because many of my mugs are just, I wanna say good looking, but those are not that good looking actually, so I just use many colors and try to build something from my pieces. Of course I have some exceptions, and many characters evolve after I build them, so I build something, then I look at this guy or girl or whatever, and I'm like, well, this gonna be someone with some traits. What else? Damn, I lost my thought. Oh, yeah, designs. Yeah, I have exceptions, which are mostly mugs like Gearhead, Ghost, some of my soldiers, and Cyan, I guess. But that's because they have a history. Some of my mugs, Gearhead, I mean his character, and Ghost, exist from like 2010-ish years, so they have a history. But okay, I will answer once more. Many things inspire me. Those are my dreams, random color things. Sometimes I genuinely like have an idea for, I want to make, for example, a demon girl with like spikes and something. I know this is a goddamn generic idea, but I'm just giving you an example how this can work. So I have an idea that I will probably maybe do sometime in the future, where I will build a really lanky like acid girl with black and trans lime pieces, which will look like she'll have a bent spine, if that makes sense. And yeah, so this idea just came randomly to my head, but mostly I either have some idea or I just like randomly put pieces together, so I'm not that good in character design. What was your first set? Oh, I remember this very clear. It was Pohatu Nuva, and it was year 2003. I look at Lego catalog and I was like, I asked my parents that I want this guy, because I only played Lego dinosaurs, which came in sand blue and sand green. Those exist before Bionicles. I mean, not before, but before I started playing, or just buying Bionicles. I mean, my parents buying, but whatever. So yeah, Pajata Nu was my first set, which I bought in 2003. And yo. Do you have a favorite Pokemon? Nope. Favorite Bionicle G1 character? Again, I don't know. I can answer that question. I don't know almost anyone from there. Favorite Lego color? Oh, this is a difficult question. Woo! So, I'm gonna look at my container shelf. I'm thinking, wait. I guess this would be purple from like Hero Factory G2, this kind of purple. Or trans purple, some of those two. For two reasons. First, this color was like unseen in Bionicle for a long amount of time. And the second one, I just like this color in general, so that's like win-win on both sides. So, I guess trans purple. Yeah, I like trans more. Favorite building system? Bionicle Technic CCBS. Not CCBS, 100% absolutely. I bet my ass not CCBS, but... Bionicle or Technic? Yeah, I guess Bionicle. I have a history with this, with those parts, not with... Like, Technic is absolutely necessary for your mocks. You're not a mock maker if you're not using Technic. Like, dude, come on, what the fuck? But Bionicle is better because, well, Bionicle is a Bionicle building system, and Technic is not. You can only build, like... trucks and cars from Technic and like weird large stuff, like, but Bionicle of, by the way, why you forgot system? I'm just asking. But yeah, from those three, it would be Bionicle. It's more relatable to actual Bionicles, you know. Favorite Bionicle mask design wise and favorite mask power wise I don't have a favorite power-wise mask for the same reason I don't have a favorite character. I don't know anything about the lore, basically. And design-wise... So, okay. I like things that look like gas masks or soldier helmets or stuff like that. So, I would probably say, but... Well, I warn you, this thing would sound controversial as fuck, because my favorite mask is probably Gally Mystica mask. Yeah, I said that. Yes. Whew. So, but... Oh, actually, maybe not. Maybe my favorite mask is a Chirox or Kirox or Kyrox. I don't know how you call him. I called him Chirox all my life, like everyone else in this country, so... Yeah, maybe his mask, actually, yeah. I don't know, that's a tough one. And what got you into Bionicle and LEGO as a whole? I don't remember. I guess my parents, me being a kid, interested in building stuff, so I built, like, wooden houses from... Not actual, I mean... toy wooden houses. I wasn't like a child slave or something, but yeah, then I just like, and I like I really liked dinosaurs when I was a kid, and I knew everything about them. I maybe do know many things to this day, actually, but for example, I know all those time periods and all those eras or eons, but I digress. So I like dinosaurs, I like building stuff, so I got into LEGO dinosaurs. I really liked how they looked. I had all four sets of those. Oh, actually, I remember those also have a map, Like any each of those sets have a piece of the map which you can could use for I don't remember what exactly, but yeah. And then I when I was looking at LEGO catalogs, at first I like didn't pay much attention to Bionicles, which were in 2001 and 2, those like flies with purple, not purple, that's like dark magenta. I mean this other purple from 2001 color, I don't remember its name, and orange eyes, those like weird flies. I was like, well, cool, but yeah, dinosaurs are better. But then I bought, I mean, I asked my parents about this set, as I said, in 2003. So yeah, LEGO catalogs are actually quite good. I mean, obviously that's an advertisement, but that's a cool advertisement because those are pieces, those are parts, you can use them. And LEGO dinosaurs from 2001 or 2 are awesome. Oh! How do you create a character from building to writing? So, I kinda answered this question before, but I either build someone and attach a character and personality after just by looking at this someone, or I try to think of a personality or something in a process of building, or I have like a general idea before, maybe this character came in my dream or like was a character from other media or from my other games, which is like a long story, don't like and also I try to make characters at least not the same, so I may use some cliches or whatnot, but I try for them to have some personalities, at least something, if those characters are like, if I want these characters to be recognized and remembered. It's like, it's pointless to just make mooks or like bland whatever fighters who just fight because they are good, with guys with a dark past, shadow toas with like Makuta siblings and long stories with their troubled childhoods where enemies burned the whole village and all this shit, you know what I'm talking about probably. So this is a hard process. I don't think I can really answer that, but characters live with me, so they evolve, they have a life on their own. Though I hate myself and many of my characters and my lack of ability to create something decent. Okay, something good. I can create decent things, but not good. But so yeah. Then, which Bionicle villain do you think deserved a redemption arc? I have no idea, dude. If you had the budget to make an animated feature film or series, what would it be about? Well, I think this still would be about Bionicles, and this still would feature my mocks. It probably would be a different story than I'm making right now. And I don't know, it depends on the time when this option would exist for me, because I have many ideas, I want to do many things, but I can't do everything, and many of those ideas may be like really shitty, so I need to filter my thoughts. And yeah, I need to start writing actually good scripts. Like I know that BioTube, like good script on BioTube is the unheard of thing, but I mean I don't need to look at people that are worse. I need to look at someone that's better, and I'm very not cool in terms of writing, because I actually have 2 plot holes in my second episode, which I only realized after I watched it for like 3 times. I'm fucking dumb guy in terms of writing, because well, though I have experience, I tried to write a book on Russian, and this was a really good thing for anyone who read it, but I mean this is hard. I wrote like 8% or 10%, and I like my ideas just stopped coming into my head. This is like a really hard thing to do. You need to read many stuff, you need to practice with writing, and I almost don't read because I don't have a time, and books are not that like comfortable to carry with you, and I have like a computer, so actually maybe you kids don't realize that, but when you don't have a computer, games or something like social networks, you have way more time to read stuff. Like before, I was playing computer like a bastard for like 6 hours a day, which I did before. I don't play anything anymore, but still almost anything. Like sometimes maybe I can play something, but when you have a computer, a console, a shitty phone, games for special aid kids or stuff like that, I mean, you don't have a time to read as much as you could have a time if you haven't got all this stuff. My grammar is totally messed up, I forgot what I was saying. So you need to read and to write. Read Stephen King's book about how to write books. This thing can help you like understand some things. That's actually quite interesting and short book. So yeah. And would you just recreate your web series or do something else? Yeah, I would do something else. But with Bionicles, because like Bionicles are life, obviously, like fuck that. What is your favorite mug that you've made? So in terms of a build or of the build, why are you asking such a difficult questions? Okay, in terms of a build, it's probably Primus, because that's not because this guy is giant or some or complicated or something, but that's because I don't have any problems with his build. Like I may hate all my mugs, but I hate this guy the least, I guess. And in terms of in terms of character, this is probably Crank, because this guy have a long history and I need to revamp this guy really bad, because for now this guy looks like a different version of a Strug, but his character is like totally different thing, like totally unconnected whatsoever. So this just gonna like bring some unnecessary questions. So yeah, what are some inspirations for Max? Well, those can come from cartoons or anime. Yeah, actually I have some anime inspirations, like for example Gala, this like black, silver and blue Silesian girl with like that look kinda resembles an alien with her hair or something. She was inspired by aliens from the Parasite anime, which her abilities are basically the same, so if you watch this thing you'll probably know what I'm talking about. Some or inspired, like Black One was inspired by Echo, or more not like Echo, more like his daughters from the last season, not just in like her looks, but I mean more in her abilities. Yeah, sometimes this happens with me that I watch something like anime or even a TV series maybe, and I get inspiration from there. Actually this can be quite helpful, but be wise, don't copy someone outright, and just be inspired. Don't like make your stands like many people do nowadays. Just like see designs, see the style, see the general ideas, see the creativity, and this can help you with many things. What's your history with Bionicle CCBS? Well, I kinda answered that, but I started buying Bionicles from 2003, and I bought them every single year after that. I didn't think I missed any of years in Bionicle, and I have most of the sets. Like, I think I have like 80 or 90% of them all. I don't know. And I maybe missed something from Hero Factory, because Hero Factory really sucks compared to Bionicle. Though you can use some parts. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. And yeah, I don't really like G2, but though I bought a set from each wave, so I guess this can be counted as my history. And yeah, CCBS and construction builds other than Bionicle are kinda totally garbage, like really. Like, Ben 10 is a piece of goddamn shit. It's not like, I mean, you can buy purple or magenta spikes from there or something else, but those, this is like a really step backwards from Bionicle, even maybe from 2010 sets, I don't know. And oh well, though I buy some Star Wars sets because of their shells, which can be used for ass and tits, or for legs, or for something else, or you can use their capes and weapons and whatnot. Yeah, Star Wars sets are kinda cool. They cost really much though, but any dream, goals, build ideas? So, I guess my dream and goals are to be able to create good, recognizable, relatable, memorable characters every time I make a character, except for mooks and people that aren't like, would be just killed or are there to be killed, or, but even this can be like, you can have guys that should be killed, but give them some personality, so their death won't be like, well, this guy is dead, fuck him. No, you need to have something, I guess. If those aren't intended for be victims of a mass shooting or whatnot. But build ideas, goals in build ideas, I guess would be just to make better builds. Good proportions, good piece usage, no gaps, good color blocking. This is an unreachable ideal in the way I view it, but I mean, I'm kind of far from it. I need to get much closer. So, yeah, I have many dreams and goals with my mocking, but I'm far from achieving them because I don't have a time. I'm also doing a series, so I don't have much time because of that as well. And yeah, I think you mentioned something a while back about some aspects of your story being inspired by some real-world events or ideas or concepts or something. I can't remember exactly, hence the question. What are those inspirations, and how did you go about integrating them into your series? Unless, of course, I'm just misremembering that whole thing, that I'm about to look real dumb. So no, you remember this correctly. My episode 2.5 was hardly inspired by Russian Revolution that happened in 1917, and like almost anything can be connected to that. I won't like, no, actually maybe I can give you some details. So Cyan represented Lenin, I guess the Dyson Gen was maybe represented Trotsky, and Black One I guess is a Stalin. So yeah, so like it follows, so they like cleared the country, they help the country rise from the shithole it was in that time. But after a while, people in this country got fucked. I mean, I kinda exaggerated everything by Black One killing actually, literally everyone on this planet. But I mean, this was inspired. It's not that I copied this story altogether, I guess. Yeah, maybe those, like, analogies I said before are kinda maybe not very correct, who knows. But yeah, this whole episode and whole story was inspired by this event, because I'm too stupid to think of my own story. Like, you can see that in many of my things. How long does it take you to create a usual mug of yours? I think about 4-5 hours maybe. So the smallest time would be half an hour. The largest would be like 20 something hours. But I want to rebuild most of my mugs, and I rebuild them constantly, so I don't know. That's a difficult question. I can say that like 5 hours on average, I guess, something like that. How tall is your self mug? Well, wait. So, he's 33 centimeters, or 1,105.08, 1.51337, whatever feet, I don't know. Are you a rich boy? Your mug's got a lot of parts. So, no, I'm not a rich boy, it just I started having Bionicles from 2003 and haven't missed a single year since then, and like I have most of the sets, so kinda, I mean, yeah, it just, you should know how to spend your money on Lego so you would have everything you need. Also, actually, you need some sceneries and whatnot, and like, I don't have any sceneries yet, but I'm planning to buy many stuff in the future. And better filming equipment, because my camera kinda sucks. Like, autofocus and like flickering is unremovable. It's just a feature of my camera. I can do nothing to remove this thing. But yeah. Who a better bio boy? Thatchmack v Mason Max. In what regard? In animation wise, I guess Mason's Max. Mark wise, it will be a Thatchmack. I guess for effects, it will be for sure absolutely Thatchmack. And green screen, well, Mason Max have green screen, Thatchmack not really, but Mason Max green screen is kind of flawed. But at the same time, he's quite good with green screen, so I don't know. I guess in general, I guess Thatchmack. Oh, also story writing and comedy. Comedy, Mason Max, story writing, Thatchmack. But they are kind of different, so I mean, in what regard should I compare them? Thatchmack got more points from me, but he's not that far away, and Mason Max is cool, is a cool guy, and his channel and content is cool as well, so yeah. I saw Fire Lord in your comments. Will he see this and know I don't think he deserves 61 subs? Probably. How's it feel to know your Max fingers are on par with Little Brotherhood? Well, it feels great. What biotuber do you think is the most overrated, other than TTV? TTV biotuber, yeah, right. Oh, who is the most overrated? That's an interesting question. I don't know every biotuber, so maybe I will miss the most overrated. But from my perspective, Damn, I don't know. That's a difficult question. Can I not answer that, please? I honestly don't know the answer. Maybe someone like Noah Productions. I don't know. His series seem to be kinda really overrated, but I'm not sure actually. I don't know. How does it feel to know Jalar 3 is taking longer to be released than it took for Ignition War? Well, feels bad, man. Do you think Little Brotherhood will pull a Fena and not release their videos? What's a Fena? I have the most questions, as of writing this at least. Where is my reward? So, your reward would be is that you are allowed to make a review on my channel. Yeah. So, that's all for YouTube questions. Now I would go through questions from other social networks. There is one point in your third episode that has alerted me. Are you planning to show us bad scenes or something like that? And yes, I love Russians in your series. Well, I hope not. I hope that I won't show you bad scenes or something like that. Don't know if this is top secret lore info, but do you have equivalents of werewolves and vampires? Werewolves, no for sure. Vampires, I will maybe have some. But for now, I don't have anyone. I mean, Serena Scarlet from my Maniamax contest collab entry was one of... She was a vampire originally, and she is from my others, like, completely unrelated to Bionicle's story, but for now, she is disassembled, and I will revamp her, so yeah, I guess she can count. But like, she's the only one, and she is not canon for my series, and she doesn't exist in full yet, so I guess I don't have equivalents of those two for now. What's your favorite canon Bionicle character and why? Exalara T9, because I like his canons more. Favorite set and or wave? So favorite set is a difficult one, but for favorite wave it would be Baraki. Yeah, I think this would be 2007 and Baraki, and I really like 2007 Titans. Favorite set would be, I guess, someone from Titans, maybe Rudaka. Or actually, like, someone like Maxilus, or... I don't know. No, it's really hard. I don't think I have a favorite set, so... Favorite wave is 2007 Baraki. Do you want an Italian bird with a knife to come to your house and steal your pizza rolls? Cause I can hook you up, fam. No, thanks, I'm good. If you can answer one question, what that question it will be? Not this question, for sure. What came first, Ranch or Cool Ranch? This sounds like a meme I know nothing about, so I would say Ranch because of Occam's Razor. I guess. Cool ranch is more difficult than ranch, so adding one word seems like came after, but eh. Ranch. But I know the fuck you're talking about. So this is gonna be all for my Q&A. Hope you had some fun listening to me talk about different stuff. And for my and this stuff, I'm not that good speaker for now, but I'll try to improve myself in many different matters. So thank you all for your questions. Keep up. Блять, короче, нахуй, блять, все.